Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be talking about the world's tallest living land animal, which is, can you guess what it is? It is, of course, the giraffe. So yes, that probably came as no surprise to pretty much anyone, but the giraffe is the tallest species of land animal currently alive today. And to achieve that record, they're helped out by that really long neck, which they're famous for, and also their equally long legs, which help them to run at speeds of an incredible 35 miles per hour. Giraffes currently live in fragmented populations across the savanna and open woodland of sub-Saharan Africa. And it kind of goes without saying that they're pretty easily recognisable. If you see one of these things walking around, you're probably going to know what it is. On average, a fully grown adult stands between 4.3 and 5.7 metres tall, with males being around 1 metre taller than the females. Up until recently, the consensus among scientists was that giraffes were just one species with many different subspecies. However, a study published in 2016 revealed that giraffes might actually be split into four different species entirely. The tallest of these is the Maasai giraffe, and in fact the tallest giraffe ever recorded was a male Maasai named George, who used to live at Chester Zoo, and stood at an impressive 5.8 metres tall. The tallest giraffe alive today is an individual known as Forrest, who currently lives at Australia Zoo and stands at 5.7 metres tall. Despite their extra long necks, giraffes actually have just seven neck vertebrae, the same as most other mammals. However, each of those vertebrae do measure about 25 centimetres in length, so it kind of does add up a bit. So giraffes certainly do have the advantage when it comes to feeding time, because they can get up there and get those leaves and buds from the very tops of trees that most other animals can't really reach. And also really ideal for looking out for predators as well. They're basically their own kind of watchtower, really. But giraffes also use their long necks for a very different reason. Male giraffes, known as bulls, will sometimes clash their heads and necks together in this fight for dominance, an activity that's known as necking. And it's very rarely fatal and usually just results in the defeated male getting up and walking away from the fight. And for this, I would highly recommend checking out David Attenborough's Africa series. There was a really good clip in this of two male giraffes fighting. It was really dramatic and it was brutal, but amazing. Now, of course, being that tall does have its disadvantages. Giraffes do have a little bit of a drinking problem. In order to reach the water, they have to splay their legs and bend down in quite an awkward way, which makes them really, really vulnerable to predators. Thankfully, giraffes only need to drink once every few days, as they get most of the water they need from the plants that they eat. Now, one thing I find really fascinating about giraffes is that females actually give birth standing up, which means that lovely, cute little baby giraffe is essentially welcomed into the world with a 5-foot drop. And that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed it and you're as fascinated by giraffes as I am. They are amazing animals. I absolutely love them. I probably say that about everything, but yeah, they're amazing. So yeah, be sure to hit that subscribe button for more wildlife related content coming in the future. I'm really excited to be back posting videos again. And yeah, check out my social media. I'll put all this in the description below the video. And yeah, hopefully see you again in another video very soon.